Welcome back to my small show on YouTube. Excuse me if I sound a little bit, you know, short on breath. It's because I had to hurry to set it up, because I'm using sunlight. It's very difficult for a lo-fi, low-tech guy like me to show a video and still be not in the dark. So I will just push the button. If it works, it's maximum the hormone. We got a commercial. It's a video game. It's not the game I'm playing. I'm actually playing Stellar Blade. So if I'm not making videos, I'm probably on my PS5 playing Stellar Blade. Anywho, no thank you. Oh my God. As heavy as I expected. I love that.
also that melody, you know.
Man Olivas. Jesus Christus. Wow. I'm just gonna switch it off. I just saw him on my way back. I thought it was Finnish. I guess it was. It looked like it's some kind of a commercial. So I hope we are good. I'm gonna check it out afterwards. Not now, because I just shut the whole goddamn thing off. And I gotta catch, you know, my breath again. Yeah, if you're wondering what the t-shirt is, you know. Maybe we can do the intro melody reaction, I don't know, to part three, you know. That's another topic. I'm trying to gather my thoughts. Yes, I know Maximum the Hormone, but I only heard one song from the girls featuring, you know, in the video. Hatarashigako. That's my newfound. I think I'm gonna, you know, I already ordered a Atarashi. I was about to say Hatarashi. Atarashigako. Yeah. CD. The one I just made of the Otona Brew. It's a 5-song CD. But I had to have it to check them out further. But then now I can explain. I have my thoughts back. Thank you. And yes, right after I can't remember. I remember it was a subscriber, I guess. Excuse me for not remembering the name, that suggested, now that I discovered the Atarashi Gakko, no? I should check this one out. So, yeah, check. Check the check. I immediately jumped that opportunity when I read it. I remember because I have been for a couple of years a big Maximum the Hormone fan. I don't know, 5 years or something. Since this channel was, you can go back, it's not 5 years, 3 years maybe. I don't know now. Time flies, man. It feels like 5 years, but I guess it's less. I have the big book, you know, the one with the, I done the video on it. So you can go back and maybe I should make, I'm gonna check if there's a list, you know, playlist. This will be part of the Maximum playlist, if not, excuse me, I'm trying to catch my thought. If I don't have it, it will be there. That was what I was trying to say. Man, that was hard after this song. And I have to also mention, apropos the album I got with the, you know, the one with Frieza and all the good stuff. You got other good albums, I know, from Maximum a lot, but I only got that one, you know, the big book. And that's a good place to start. I'm to this day, I'm never close to getting just a little teensy bit bored about that album. It's great. As I said, you can go back and watch the videos. It's fantastic. The they have for many years been, as far as I know, masters in mixing the genres. And I think I mentioned a lot the German band Der Tote Hosen, especially when the, you know, the guy with the beard and the, you know, the one who sings more than growling, when he does that, he also screams, shouts, growls, you know, everybody in that, in Maximum can do everything, as far as I know. But you know what I'm talking about. That, and he just hits that note, that same kind of, yeah, notes that Der Tote Hosen does. You should go check some of their best work out. Maybe I would put it on the channel without getting into further details, because we are talking about this and another group, Ataraji Gakko, in this video. For the most part, I hope. I'm trying to, at least. So far, the light are with us, so I must be doing something right. So, I'm just gonna have a little sip of coffee before getting to my review part further. Man, that was a blast. And we're living in times where we got a lot of collaborations, success stories, you know. Recently from Japan was, you know, the Baby Metal / Electric Callboy, you know. AKA Eskimo back in the days, Callboy. With the huge success, I even heard that being played a lot in WWE promos. I think it was the Bad Blood, you know, spots where they used that music to. At one point I saw a hole where you just heard the whole number, ra ta 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 ta, and you saw clips with, you know, Rhea Ripley and the gang. But in this, you know, particular instance, the Shimi, was that the name? I forgot it. It's too late. It's gone from the telly. Something like Shimi. Maybe it was just Shimi. But yeah, I will correct it if I'm wrong on the, you know, screen. Old school Maximum the Hormone, as I'm trying to describe. You know, and you can't go wrong with that, you know, the real heavy, slouchy, old school inspired, you know, going all the way back to Black Sabbath, I guess, the doomy rhythm, they started out with, that was very old school. It sounded almost like a melody you knew in before it started, you know what I mean? You know, like real classic stuff. Do 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 do. I'm not even sure if maybe that is some kind of homage to something I have forgot. And then they got into the blast rhythm, almost punk rocky hardcore, I guess. Death metal ish music style, real fast, and as we are used to what they are masters at also. And then they, I think at that point, they, I can't remember if they went from that to the more happy, the you know, the singing part from the Maximum Hormone, the one with the beard, the something like that. Can't remember. He was singing in Japanese, so, you know, I'm from Denmark. but again, a classic way of making a, I guess, a verse or a chorus. Was it a chorus? But that was at the point where we got the introduction with, and I love the way we saw them sitting, like, and just headbanging. Reminded me of early baby metal. Again, some comparison. You know the videos, the headbanger video with the neck piece. And you can even argue, but anywho. Great, great stuff from and again the voice, the lead singer from Atarashi Gakko, and as I told you, I already bought a CD. It's on the way. It should be here in a few days from Germany. Anyways, and I was just crazy good. And then we get back in front, you know, we got the whole deal again. And as soon as we knew, thought we knew, aha, yes, we're gonna go have this. No, it was going into banjo, fucking, you know, almost banjo dueling style from that movie. But, you know, in Asian, a crazy, it's original Asian, that and yes, and a hip hop bridge, I guess. I don't know. At this point, I don't know what where we are in the song. That was at the final act, I would call it, first impression. And I can actually not remember in which part they ended the story, the song. Oh yeah, the great sing along, and the great reveal. That made my, you know, I had to check, am I seeing right? Because I'm looking at a smaller screen this way. I guess it was the drummer. I forgot her name now, from Maximum, in some kind of, you know, authentic outfit. You know, real classic. Back from the, I was about to say, Kung Fu films. That's my knowledge, you know. But you know, Shogun area. I don't know what you call it, kabuki. Clothing, Peking opera. I don't know. I'm reaching. Anywho, she was beautiful. Almost like, you know, some kind of saint. Singing the last part from I guess the female side of the song. And that was a big surprise, because that could have been a missed opportunity not to collect all the girls in one shot. That was kind of beautiful, the more I think of it now. We kind of had a separation. The girl from Maximum, the hormone, jumped over to in the video in the final act and got part of that group, you know, for a short while as a special guest in their scene, because we saw them separately most of the time, as far as I remember. The Atarashi Gakko were doing, and oh yeah, at one point also the megaphone part. We even got a megaphone part, a Rage Against the Machine part, you know what I mean? Shouting in the bullhorn on top of the building. Yeah, that's Rage Against the Machine, I guess. They own it. But you can borrow it, and they did it real cool. You know what I mean? This music is a celebration of what they love. Also, the baby metal electric, that hawks back into old school 90, you know. I'm not thinking about only one number now, but in generally, all of these bands who mixes and matches, they are, in my opinion, celebrating old school cool shit. It's very... it's very, you know, underground. to think like that. But it's also very punk rock to think like that. Very Generation X. I'm a Gen X. It's inventive. So I was rambling, I guess, and the sun is almost going down. So that's a good time to stop the video. I would give this was just as good as I was referring to the Baby Metal Electric collab we also got this year, so I guess it's fair to bring that up. And can we get more of this? I know we got tons more I could have mentioned, you know, even with Baby Metal. And this is the first time, because Atala Chicago is new to me, I see them with another band, of course. And I also think it's the first time I've seen Maximum do a featuring in this scale. So as far as I remember, as a 10 out of 10, it's just as good as anything else. That's my first impression. I would love to have this on vinyl. You know what I mean? It's like, that'll be the day. I guess it will be the same day as I will own Ratatata on vinyl. You know, like, yeah, man. I guess it's not gonna happen soon. But I have faith. And one day I will have them on some kind of media. That's it. Thank you for watching. Domo. Arigato. It was a pleasure. From Denmark. With love. Did I say you know I love you? I think I did. Honestly can't remember. If it only in my head. So. That being said. See you in the next video. Bye now.